What's going on, everyone? Wanted to do another quick tip video for you all. So I got a lot of questions asking how to eliminate tape drag in corners. So there's no real way to eliminate it altogether, but you can compensate for it. So what you want to do is advance yourself some tape. You could do that manually by turning your drive dog, or you could prime your head by running it up the wall and then raising your tape. Regardless, you wanna give yourself a few inches, I'd say about 3 to 4 inches of lead tape to compensate for that drag. So you'll see here, I'm gonna put the head up in the wall, kind of jam it in the corner there. I'm gonna start to roll away, and then as soon as I'm able to get my creaser trigger in there, you wanna push that creaser trigger in there to wedge that tape, and then that helps compensate for the drag. Now, usually when you start rolling down the wall about 5 or 6 feet, that's about as much drag as the tape is going to allow, because then you have enough resistance to hold the tape. So if you leave yourself too much tape, you could always just pinch it right here and then slowly pull the tape, and you can see along the wall over there that the tape starts to roll down the wall. So you can't eliminate it altogether, but you can compensate for it. You can see right there how nice and tight we are. So just a little trick for you all. And likewise, when you're taping your upright corners, same thing applies. We'll start at the bottom there. And if you get some drag at the bottom, like you can see there, then just give yourself a few extra inches along the top. So you can see my tape is overlapped up to the ceiling. And then you can simply just pull it down. So you can see there, now we're nice and tight. And now we're a little closer to the bottom, so the baseboard's gonna hide that, no problem.